Hello there, and welcome back, everybody, to the Gems of Power, our weekly D&D 5e session. Let me give you our cast. There we go. Cast, you're alive. You guys
Hooray! Have
entered the dungeon, and you wake up. You don't know how much time has passed.
Can I expend hit dice?
1 second. All of you wake up. And you have no wounds on you. You feel rested. You feel good. Very good, actually.
That's what I like to hear.
So is our HP restored now? Or
yeah.
Yeah, it is, sir.
I'm immediately checking to make sure the money's still there. I'm just like...
just...
Spell slots, Chucky?
Spell slots back, HP back, all half of your hit dice rounded up back.
Have I got my money?
You have your money.
Finn just giving herself a quick pat down.
I'm gonna drink from my tankard. My tankard. I'm gonna take a little swig to wake up, get ready for whatever the hell is just happening.
Like, so guys, unfortunately, Roll20 doesn't have this song right now, so if you want to put on some ambient music for your softwares because the chat use it, it's Dungeon 1 on the link I just sent. Because tabletop audio is an amazing place to get music for your D&D shows. Tabletopaudio.com.
What was it, sorry?
Sponsor us.
Well, they actually do. They have given me the permission to use the music on, so that's nice. Cool for them.
It's
just amazing. Okay, so the creature, the ghost, is not there anymore. The circle of blue flame is gone.
Okay.
What happened? What happened, guys? Did any of you
fell asleep?
Can I make an arcana check to see if I can tell what happened?
Definitely, yeah.
Awesome.
Moving forward a little, Chucky, what am I seeing on the left and right there?
One second. So because you have dark vision, give you a bit more here.
I got a 5.
So you have absolutely no idea what just happened.
I think we were enspelled by a sleep spell, everybody.
So you start moving forward, and you see what seem to be scarecrows, partly armored.
Is the door still open behind us, or did it close?
The door is closed behind you.
And well, that's a good thing and a bad thing.
You see their backs. Chew the pillars.
Okay, I'm going to immediately point out the fact that there's one missing, just like, because it looks like there should be 6 because there are 6 pillars and there's one missing. So Findira like points over and she's like, something missing.
Reginald,
I walk.
Reginald, stop there. Give me a dexterity saving throw.
Oh, back over there.
Okay. Yep.
Okay, I got this. My dex saves are average.
You don't want to go over that! Oh.
Yes!
And you all hear, so this is basically a cringe moment in which it is complete silence, and all of you hear a panel being stepped on. You see Reginald's face, and then the scarecrow's arms go up.
Wait, there's no scarecrow. I'm right next to the spot where there is
not to you, Reginald. All of the others go up.
Oh, okay, awesome.
And they move.
Give me
initiative.
I'm in the dark. Can I hide in like just shadows?
Definitely, yeah, definitely. But give me initiative because nobody expected this.
Is that 1d20 plus 6? Is it for me?
1d20 plus 6, No. Initiative is only dexterity. You don't have a proficiency in initiative. Right, so just a 1d20 plus 4.
Okay.
Okay.
24.
Let me just get you my scarecrows and place over on here.
Fuzzy's dice are broken.
Yes.
Yes. Fucking 20.
But why do you complain?
I'm not complaining. It's just like what?
Trust me. Okay. If you start saying too much, the gods of Roll20 is gonna hear them. They're gonna hear them.
Her luck is gonna run out at some point. Like it has to.
Probably a really critical moment as well.
Yeah. Well, exactly.
Yeah, that's usually what happens. The star usually goes down in a very critical moment. Okay, so let's add our turn order as always and make this very easy for all of our players in chat. There we go.
Right.
Bjorn, Finwazi, add in your initiative. The turn order should just appear on your screen right now. And let us change the music to battle music.
Just keep doing it.
Yes, I made it work.
Fine. Eventually, it doesn't work if somebody else is inputting at the same time. So basically, you just have to keep doing it until you're the only person.
I see. You guys told me this, and I should have remembered from last time.
Isn't there a way to roll initiative and have it automatically appear in the turn order?
Yes.
Probably have to use the initiative macro from the character sheet.
You have to use the initiative macro for the character sheet and assign your token to the character sheet. Yeah. Trust me, it's way too too much work and not worth it.
These scarecrows, what are they what are they made of?
So they seem to be made out of cloth, hay, and they have actual iron masks on their face with engravings of the Allfather.
Right. I'm gonna shout, they look kinda flammable, and then just like try and recede into the shadows.
So Reginald, also you see this you see this rune in the ground behind one of the scarecrows just below it's glowing. Bjorn, remember you have a torch in hand.
I'm gonna jump straight on. It's my turn, right?
Okay, so no, it's currently, let's see, we have Finwazi first.
Oh, okay.
So Finwazi, what's up? Do you have any dark vision, by the way?
I'm a halfling, I don't know.
Check your actor sheet.
Oh God.
It's important because you're out of right. Like you're not in right, so if you don't have any dark vision, it could be bad for you. Let me check it for you.
Yeah.
There we go. Natural. Nope. You do not have dark vision.
Okay. Right. So all I can see really is what's in the light.
All you can see is what is in the right in front of you. Yes, you're completely hidden from sight. You're in darkness.
Right. In that case, I am going to...
What are you going to do? Come on.
I'm just going to wait this turn out, I think. I'm just going to be like, I'm just going to suss out what's going on. So I'll just prepare myself. If anything comes out of the darkness at me, I'm just going to be like, ready to like dive out of the way or whatever, but I'm just like...
Your preferred action is to run away if somebody comes towards you.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Awesome.
But I'm just saying, I don't know how much damage arrows are going to do against something made of straw, so I'm just like, I don't know, man.
Okay. Gregor. One. Actually, two of them are facing you directly. What do you do?
I'll cast Shillelagh as a bonus action. I know you have to roll. Anything happens.
Roll me a 1d20 real fast.
17.
The spell does not go off.
Aww. Okay. In that case, I will ready an action to attack if one comes close to me, I'll attack it with a torch.
Okay, so that is your action, and next in line we have Bjorn Iron Fist.
I'm gonna enrage, guys. Let's bring this out.
Yeah!
I'm gonna pick up my hammer, my little stick of fire, and I'm gonna charge straight in on this one right here.
Awesome. Check up your hammer.
I'm gonna take a swing.
Go on, go. Give me your attack. Okay, you hold advantage because you also raged, am I correct?
Yep.
Okay. Is somebody sleeping in your house?
No. Are you ready? I'm gonna come straight in, hammer up, flame in the upper hand, and I'm gonna come in and swipe straight for the guy, straight for the torso.
I'm gonna tower it up. Sounds good.
Tower it up! Fire and hammer, here we go. Alright, so.
Give me the damage, that's a hit.
Alright, let's do this. It's a 1d6, right? Because of the.
One, the 8.
Because I don't have. It is an 8, okay.
It is an 8. 1d8 plus your strength modifier.
Plus your rage bonus.
Of 2.
Yeah.
Okay, you take up your hammer and you you crash it down on the scarecrows. They don't seem to take as much damage as actually you would have expected from this mighty of a blow. All of you notice this.
Are we hitting it with the hammer or with the torch?
Hit with a hammer.
Wait, what? Wait, what?
So, oh, wait. When you hit it with a hammer...
I can attack with both, right?
When you hit with a hammer, it seems that it takes a lot less damage than you've expected. To attack with your secondary hand, because it's a torch and it's a light weapon, you need to use your bonus action, which you have already used, to rage. So you can't do it now. You will be able to do it next turn.
Okay, now...
So it's basically... Okay. Action! Bonus action! To attack with the other hand.
Okay.
Next in line, Reginald Scales Pretor.
Moves back over here, like, oh my god, there's a thing! And circle strafes and throws a firebolt at it.
Okay, you throw a firebolt at the one over on there.
But I have back attack, right? So I get advantage?
You have back attack and you get advantage.
Right, but it is firebolt, so I don't know if you need to make some sort of magical check in the secret background area. 22 to hit.
Oh shit! Okay. I will let you roll you this. Give me a 1d100.
Okay.
And just remember, when I ask for a 1d100, expect bad things to happen.
Yeah. 26?
Okay, that's...
Do I take 26 points of damage?
No. So, you cast your spell. Roll to it. Okay, roll damage.
I'm just double checking. Ooh, it is a d10 with no modifier.
You take 3 points of fire damage as the fireball just explodes into your arm, splinters of wood into your skin.
Why are there splinters of wood in my skin?
Because it's a fire, it's not a bolt made of fire, it's a firebolt. You fire a bolt, a magical bolt.
Oh, I'm actually throwing like a bolt made of wood that is on fire?
Yes, it's a firebolt, it's not firebolt like in the elemental fire, it's firebolt. Like, fire a bolt, as in the action of fire.
Right, no, but firebolt is a spell. So, like, it conjures a piece of wood that is on fire that I throw at people?
Yeah, that's exactly what you do. You don't actually throw it completely. It's like, it's
so
basically
I'm throwing,
fries,
like,
yeah.
D10, like, pieces of wood that magically appear in my hand.
Yeah. Basically like that, yeah.
Goddamn wizards.
Okay,
it's
okay.
Weird.
I've been completely imagining this the other way.
I
assumed that it was just fire.
I think Chucky just wants it to be a bolt. He heard the bolt word and he's like, that would be so much cooler if there was throwing piece of wood.
Yeah.
It's on fire.
Like, I know.
Just extreme pub dogs.
No, okay. Wait, no. It literally says in the description, you hurl a mote of fire at a creature or object within range. It's it's a ball of flame.
Yeah, but
there's no wood.
There's wood in this world.
Okay.
Oh!
Ah!
Good to know, because this is going to bite you in the ass later, Chucky. Trust me. Trust me. Alright, I get splinters of wood in me, and I take 3 damage.
Okay.
You got some tweezers.
I'm content.
Those are some nasty splinters.
Okay.
You're going to regret making this decision.
Okay, I know what you're thinking. I know what you're thinking. Mass production has never worked for you, Neo.
Mass production? No.
Okay, so, let's continue on and see what the scarecrows do. Okay, so next in line, it'll be moving out and it's trying to attack you. This one over on here turns around towards Reginald and moves towards him. This one, there are a couple of ones coming in through the darkness. Moving. One of them Witch is Fendua, but doesn't have enough movement left to attack. The other Witch is Fendua and does have enough movement to attack. Making two claws attack at Fendua. Okay, that is a 9 and a 6.
It moves and gets two attacks? What a badass.
Yep. And it fails, it hits, and the one in front of Bjorn looks at you, Bjorn. You can see burning eyes behind the iron helmet. Roll me a wisdom saving throw.
Ooh, boy. Correct me if I'm wrong, right?
No, that's alright. You just add your wisdom modifier if you have any. 19 is enough. The creature is trying to frighten you. But your resolution, your fortitude is too big for something like that.
I'm gonna spit in his face.
Okay, so, Fendua, give me a perception check.
Okie dokie.
Okay, nope, you don't notice anything. Okay, I forgot to give Chad like the vision of dark vision. You know what? No, we're not gonna give Chad the vision of dark vision.
Seeing, I mean, I can see on the ground that something is glowing, right?
That's a tease. That's a tease, Checky.
You know what? You know what? It just feels the smaller circle of lights just feels more better on the map. So we're gonna use that.
So it's more intimate. So I can see like 5 things on the ground, Chucky. Is the one that's different the one that's glowing, or are the others all glowing and the
The map is truth to the map. You see it however you see it.
Okay, but that doesn't help me because representationally, I have no idea which one is the glowing one. Like, I assume that would be obvious, right?
Yes, it is definitely obvious that the one in front of Bjorn glows completely. Okay. And the one you can see in the back, the one that seems different, doesn't grow, and you see a scarecrow that is not moving in front of it.
Indeed, I was just gonna say that.
Exactly.
Okay.
Fendua.
All right.
Not yet your turn. I wanted to attack Reginald as well. Completely forgot about that. Reginald, 18 to hit.
Why? Does he even know that I'm there?
Yes, he moved there. 18 to hit and a 9 to hit.
I was on his peripheral. When he summoned and I moved
and
before him,
and then you exploded.
It's possible.
You just went
behind
back,
him.
Okay?
Behind him. But look at all that noise and clatter in front of him. And it didn't go bang. Remember, there's no explosion. A just piece of wood hit me. It's fine.
A piece of firewood, like wood on fire.
Yeah, but it was behind him.
Oh, you just got a load of splinters in there. You wouldn't have gone ow or something.
Well, I might have, but I think the four of you over there are more distracting. Whatever.
What are you looking at? Three, thank you. Three. I'm not distracting. Nobody knows I'm there.
The elf counts for two. It's not only distracted, but distracting elf.
What? I'm
okay.
A gnome.
And
yeah.
you get hit, my friend. Now, when this hits you, your whole body starts to tremble, and your mind is overwhelmed by feelings of fear. Give me a wisdom saving throw.
Haha! 11.
Okay, 11 is you barely overcome the screams and the frightening agony in your head, but you still take 7 points of damage.
Just kill me already!
Slashing. Okay, and that is the end of the Skelko's turn. Next in line after that, Fendua.
Wait, I take half damage from fire sources. That bolt would not have hurt me for as much.
You would have done one.
Yeah.
That was wood damage, Neil, not fire damage.
It specifically says fire damage in the rules.
It's fire damage, it's fire damage.
Alright, so Fendua. God, out of character, I think I know what to do, but Fendua is not me out of character, so she's just gonna punch the crap out of one of these scarecrows.
Okay, which one? The one above or the one below?
The bottom one.
Do it.
Okay. So it's that, I think. That's the quarterstaff. Then
awesome, that's a hit.
Then the follow-up flurry.
Ooh, all of those hits roll me damage.
I shall.
I lied. I don't take half damage from fire.
Uh-huh.
What?
I'm just sick, okay?
Love that. Okay. All of your hits do significantly less damage than you would have expected.
Yes, so it's a grand total of 12, 16 damage.
Okay.
She just pummels it like a training dummy.
Exactly. And it seems like you aren't doing that much damage. Finn the Rossi, you're in the shadows. You see all that they're seeing in the light.
Mm-hmm. Right. If we've got torches, we've got ways to light, right? I would have like a flint and tinder or something, yeah? Something like that to light my torch with, yeah?
Yep, you can light a torch if you want to.
No. What I'm going to do is... Wait, how far can I move on a turn?
About, you'll have a nimbleness, I think 35 for you, if I'm correct. You should have that down in your notes.
I should, but...
It's okay. Yeah, I think you have 35 because of the halfing, the type of halfing you are.
Yeah, okay. Well, I probably can't get... Yeah, can't get over there. So I'm just going to sneak up, like... Right behind, sort of what I'm gonna sneak up over here for now, behind the two things.
So, okay, yeah. So give me a stealth check.
That's right. 20 plus
6. 10. Okay. Well, they see you.
Oh, crap.
As you move, you're not stealthed and you know it. As the creatures. Just look at you for a couple of seconds, their eyes framing behind the iron masks. Iron, actually, helmets. Okay. So next thing, I mean, you still have, you still fast as a bonus action, you moved as your movement action, you still have your action if you want to. So you can shoot, you can light a torch if you want to.
Would I be able to, like, tear a little bit, with my bonus action, would I be able to tear something off a thing, wrap around the arrow and try and light it?
Definitely, yeah.
Oh, yeah? Okay, right, in that case, I'm going to tear a bit off my robe, I'm just going to be like, and like, could I fire it as well, or would that
next turn. Right, you need to light it up.
In that case, I will just get this thing, like, sort of get a fire arrow ready, and then, like, I'm going to light it and fire it next turn.
Awesome. Great. So. Gregor.
Okay. So, is this room to scale?
This room's to scale, yeah.
I can't figure out how this is supposed to test our strength.
You have several things right on there.
I know.
I don't know, I think our strength is being tested. These things take no damage. That's pretty strong.
I'm gonna walk over here and stand on the thing. Does anything happen?
Nothing happens, but there is brilliant light around you. And you can see as you walk on it, you can see just in the darkness, actually. It's pretty weird. It's like you know where they are. You can see other emblems went throughout the room. Three of them lit as the one you have, and one unlit. Straight
Step
forward.
Step on the lights!
One of them's unlit?
One of them is unlit, yeah.
Do I know where it is?
Straight forward in front of you. On the other side of the room.
I walk towards it. I'm gonna take a note. Well, I'm only gonna take a note from that scarecrow if he decides to turn around.
This is like your normal movement, so you can continue on your movement afterwards if you want to use your action as a movement.
I'm gonna dash.
So you move over in here and you see another scarecrow, but this one's not moving, and the emblem behind it is unlit.
So I walk around him. I should have enough movement to get there. Yeah. Well, no. Actually, I might need to wait one turn.
No, you'd be here.
So it was here to here. I'd be here. Okay, I'll have to wait another turn.
Hopefully.
Yeah, this is what I get. Okay.
Oh, I will cast Shillelagh on my staff again as a bonus action.
Awesome. Let's see what happens. Nothing. Your Shillelagh goes off. Always good.
Nailed it.
Bjorn Iron Fist.
What up, Pookie? Right, I'm gonna take my torch this time. And I'm the one in front of me right now. I'm just gonna take this, and I'm gonna go straight for the torso, jab it straight into the torso so it locks in there. Because this time I'm not making the same mistake of hitting it with metal. So,
yeah. Okay, that's awesome. So you do this as your main attack. So you basically exchange hands for your weapons. Give me your attack.
Okay. It still stays 2D, right?
Simple weapon, and you have a proficiency with simple weapons, so you can use that. It's a 1d20 plus your strength. There's still 2 dice because you're raging.
Oh, I can... Alright, well, I hit.
Oh, yeah, you hit. Just roll another 1d20 to see if you quit. Okay.
Alright.
It's always possible. Especially when you have advantage.
Oh god, critical torch.
Critical torch. Nope, you just hit. Now roll me damage. And the damage for a torch is going to be a 1d4. If I am correct, as an improvised weapon. Is it the 1d6? This I don't know. Ugh. Let me check. Let's check our weapons and see if I am taking out a bit of your... Weapons. Where do we have our weapons? 146. There we go.
So, 1d4...
One second, let me just find the torch and make sure that you can actually use this and how much damage it does. Well, it's not here.
It's kind of tense, guys. It's
not here.
Oh, boy.
I'm just gonna give it... One job.
Let's go, 1d4. 1d4, it's not in the book. So, 1d4 damage plus your strength modifier. Awesome, 8 points of damage. You do exactly as much damage as you'd have expected. And the creature is severely damaged by this.
Is it burning now? Is it on fire?
It is not yet on fire, but he jabbed it in inside. So if the creature doesn't start, if the creature doesn't start taking it out, it's gonna be on fire.
Sweet! Good strategy.
Yep, I think I'm done there.
Did we lose him?
I don't know.
Chucky? Gone?
I'm here. Sorry. I was just notified that heating was not gonna be a thing tonight, so I should close all my windows.
Ah.
Yeah. Yes, that's cool. No heating for me. That's gorgeous.
There's a lot of heating for these scarecrows.
A lot of heating for the scarecrows. So, yeah. Bjorn, you still have your bonus action, so you can attack with your Warhammer. Actually, no, your Warhammer is not a light weapon, so you can't attack with your bonus action.
No. Yeah, he needs to be dual-wielding light weapons.
That's it!
But as a bonus action, though, because I've left a torch in, am I allowed to have another torch? Can I, like... ignite a new torch, or is that not a doable thing?
Taking out a new item. It's from your pack, you don't have them like on hand. Yeah, so it'll take
you. Hold on a minute!
Gone?
So I could do it? I could just.
No, you could do it next turn because it's not on you. Like, you don't have it in the bandolier. Torch. You have it in your backpack, so you need to search for it to find it.
Okay. Then that's it. It's not that. That's not it. I'm coming back in. No, I'm not. No, it's not. That's right, I dropped my weapon a minute ago. I dropped it, I think, right?
Or switched hands. Yes, you did. You dropped your weapon. Reginald! What's up, Reginald?
Okay, I'm going to cast Firebolt, and since it's a bolt of wood that I actually conjure, I'm going to stab instead of throw so I don't get disadvantaged for making a missile attack at melee range.
Put it like this, it flies out of your hand, like this.
Oh, cool, then I don't have to make melee, then I don't get disadvantage either, because it flies out of my hand out of its own accord.
No, it's still a disadvantage on a ranged attack.
Okay, then I keep my hand closed when I cast it so it summons in my hand and then I stab with it.
You do realize it's a flaming piece of wood that appears in your hand. Naked hand, flaming wood. Yeah. Hand that's splintered and singed from the other flame bolt.
So is it the entire thing is on fire all at once? It's like just a burning log.
It's not a log. It's a bolt. A bolt is not a log.
This conversation is cold.
Yes, your hand explodes. I'm just joking. So give me a disadvantage attack on this creature.
Why don't you make your roll to see if I die first?
You need to roll your attack first, but the spell
does go off.
I need
to roll my
attack
before you roll your thing?
Yes.
It must be part of the algorithm, Neil.
It must be.
But the spell goes off with no issue. Let's see now if you actually hit or not.
Yeah, even with disadvantage, I hit.
You hit.
Wow.
Roll me that
and
damage.
It's fire against a scarecrow. I'm hoping for some sort of damage buff here, but if not, it's just a measly 3. Yeah.
You do a lot more damage than you expected.
Haha.
Haha.
Hold on, I need to double check, see which of these spells are bonus actions and which ones are not.
No problem. We're sitting here looking at Justin's pussy. It's all good. What's her name? Or his name?
Dark Matter.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Okay, I remember.
No.
Of course it is, Justin.
It is. And my other cat's name's Krebs Cycle.
And the third cat that you want to get is going to be named?
The Maillard Reaction.
I'd like to make an offhand attack with my dagger at the creature.
Do it.
Excellent. RD20 plus 2.
Okay, with your secondary attack, you just stab the creature right in the neck, and you do it. Roll me your damage.
Aha. For 3, my dagger's
3 points of damage.
Flaming bolts.
But this is actually less effective, a lot less effective. You barely scratch it.
Point of order, are my flaming logs tipped in metal, or are they just pointy sticks?
Just pointy sticks.
So they're not really bolts, then. They're just pointy sticks.
Put it like this. There's a bolt, there's flame around it, it flies out of your hand.
But bolts usually have some sort of metal head at the end of it.
Okay, you've never actually seen the firebolt long enough to actually manage
it. It embedded itself in me!
Splinters. That's all you saw.
Was there a metal bolt's head on the ground at that point in time?
Do you start looking around the ground?
Alright. To be resolved later, Chucky. Take your time to think about how you want this to play out. I'm done.
Okay, so the creature's turn. Now this one in front of you, Reginald, is going to stare deeply into your eyes, trying to frighten you away. Give me a wisdom saving throw.
I blink.
What do you pull?
And let's see what happens there. And Findira. Okay, so
I'm frightened.
Reginald, you are frightened, and you are paralyzed until the scarecrow's next end turn.
Really need to bring a free action.
Okay, yes, of course. Like you ever had that in 5e until now. Have you even used it in like other roleplay shows?
A ring of free action?
Yeah.
No. But I have them in Angband all the time.
Well. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, next in line after that, Fundia is going to get crawled 2 pieces. Well, not really, because the one above misses and the one below. Wow. That is a 13 and a 22.
Okay, Fendira? Well, a 22 hits, but a 13 does not.
Okay, give me a wisdom saving throw as that hits you.
Okie dokie.
You take 6 points of slashing damage.
I don't think I pass.
You do not pass, and you are frightened until the scarecrow's end turn. You're not paralyzed, but you're frightened, so you have disadvantage against the creature, attacking that specific creature.
Only specifically that one?
Only specifically the one below, yes.
Cool.
Okay. After that, the one in front of Bjorn is going to crawl him down as well. Bjorn, one of the hits claws a gash into your chest. You take 8 points of slashing damage.
It's a good thing you have a lot of health.
Right? Yep.
Also, wow. you have a resistance bow that 8 yeah. would turn into a 4. And give me a wisdom saving throw. Yoko, you're not frightened. Findira, are you gonna show them who's boss?
Of course. But I'm not gonna attack the one that scared me because I'm scared. So I'm gonna attack the other one and spread my damage around.
Did
like
you
a total near.
Did you write down the damage that you took?
Yeah.
No, I'm talking to Cram Tackle.
Oh.
Oh wait, sorry, what?
You need to write down the damage you took.
Oh, I did. I don't know if it's updated for you though.
No, it's cool. If you have it updated for you, that's all you need.
Oh yeah.
Go Findira.
I got it.
Okay, so Findira is going to, instead of punching at the one she's already hit, she's gonna just go like, and spin her quarterstaff around and try and smack the head off of the one above her there.
Hi!
Wichita! So, quarterstaff, fist for a flurry.
Hit, and the last one is a hit. The 8 is a miss.
Cool. Oh, 11 damage.
11 points of damage. You do significantly less than you expected.
I know, but it's cool.
It's all good. Finn Rossi.
Right.
The creature in the darkness. You're not out in darkness anymore. You light. Are you still continuing to fire?
So I light my. I'm just like right. Light the arrow, and I'm just like, well, shit.
Which one do you
what
hit?
Can I see now? Well, if I've lit the, can I aim at the one I can see after I've lit the arrow? Because I can't see.
Yes.
See one of them at the moment.
Yeah. So you lit the arrow, and for a couple of seconds you see around you.
Uh-huh.
Here we go.
Right. In that case, I'm going to fire at the one closest to me.
Okay, you fire the one closest to you. Roll me to hit with an advantage as well.
Crap. Right. What do I roll for? What do I roll for that,
Jeffy? 1d20. 2d20 plus 6, which is your attack. Basically, your dex plus your proficiency, as always.
And it's a flaming arrow, and I hit 35.
It hits. The 16, that's you actually rolled a 22, the highest one, so that's a hit. So roll me the damage. So you have a 1d6 plus a 1d4 of fire damage. Plus an additional 1d6 for your sneak attack.
So, hang on. So, I'm going to roll 1d6 plus 1d4.
Press 1d6. That should be your attack.
So, 1d6 plus 4, 1d4 plus 1d6, right?
Yes. Okay. The fire significantly helps you damage this creature, and the rest doesn't do as much damage as you'd expect, but overall you do damage this creature. It seems to be half, is like part of it is starting to burn up. The creature in front of Bjorn, I completely forgot. Bjorn, roll me a 1d4.
Oh yeah, I was just gonna bring that up, by the way. There's no bonus,
perfect.
Right? Because it's still in there, right?
So basically, the fire, as I'm taking it, if you don't put up a fire on a creature, even you or another creature, especially one that has a damage vulnerability to fire, it's going to start growing. So the fire is gonna do more damage each turn, exponentially.
Oh god!
I haven't finished my turn, by the way. I'm then gonna.
Yeah, no problem. This is like before your turn. Okay. I completely forgot about it. So roll me that 1d4. Perfect, 4. Oh, wow. You burn this creature up, and actually it burns to ash. The creature is dead, and behind you, you can see the rune that was growing is now not growing anymore. It's completely gone out.
Oh.
Okay, and Finn Rossi, continue on your turn.
Right, what was I? Right. How many? Right. So I've just attacked. So now, right. I'm going to and then prepare another bolt for next turn.
Yep. No problem. Another. So you use the rest of your turn to prepare your bolt.
Can I do this while sidling away from the creature? Or?
No, you have to use your movement and your bonus to do this because you normally use a full action to do that.
Right. Okay.
Gwego Mendel.
Your mic's muted.
You're muted, mate.
You're muted.
I can't hear you.
Speak up, mate.
Cat got your
Sorry. Time. I walk around, I stand on the rune, and I try and light it with my torch.
Okay. The one below you?
Yeah.
You put your torch to the rune, and the rune starts to fade away. After about 6 seconds, so after like a full turn trying to light this rune, the rune completely actually disappears, and the scarecrow in front of you falls to shambles.
Okay, well, I guess that's one way of doing things.
Bjorn Iron Fist.
Alright.
Save me! I could use a little help!
You have Reginald, who's being cornered, paralyzed, and frightened by a scarecrow, and Fidira, who's being frightened and attacked by two scarecrows.
Oh, why you put me in this situation, guys?
Because you're the tank. This is the choices that a tank needs to make.
I mean, I guess it comes down to who you like more. Like, let's.
Well,
actually, it comes down to who's more likely to die.
The party killed less, right?
Honestly, I think I can take. I think it's better that I mitigate damage from two opponents than one little angry one. Sorry, I'm so sorry.
That's a very rational way of saying things.
See, I think that was the right call. You know,
yeah, right. I know you would. I knew you would. I'm gonna charge right on. Oh wait. First, before I move anywhere. Torches.
So you take, you need to use your action to take it out and light it. So you still have your movement, but you won't be able to attack this turn.
You know what?
Unless there's a source of fire nearby.
Unless there's a source of fire nearby.
Like maybe a flaming skeleton or a flaming scarecrow directly in front of me.
Oh.
Oh, well, your cat is so chill. I just suppressed this. Like, your cat is so chill. Go on, sorry. I'm just basically just talking to Chad as much as you decide. As long as you decide.
You know what?
I can survive if you want to help Neil, I'm pretty sure.
You think you can, right?
I mean, okay. I don't need a pity save.
oh, so now it's not good enough. I see. You
know, should I not bother saving you last?
You know what, Reggie? Alright, I'm gonna give you a timeout to clean up that dress for a moment. I'm gonna go head on over here and help out Fidira.
Okay, so where do you move, Bjorn? Move your token.
Okay, can I take my shield? I'm gonna take my shield with me.
Okay, yeah, you take your shield off the ground.
Just kick it across the floor.
Yep, kick, boom, taking it with me. Okay, so I'm gonna just light a torch, I'm gonna have my shield ready, and I'm ready to take some damage. That's it, right? Do I need to do anything to light the torch? I'm on good.
No, you're cool. You're basically just putting yourself between Fidira and the one above.
Yeah, I have health to go around. I'm fine. I don't need it anyway.
Okay, so next in line after that. Regina's Curse Splitter, you are paralyzed with fear, and you cannot do anything as the creature's claws attack you with an advantage. Missing horribly for a natural 2 and 5.
Yes!
Missing horribly for a natural 1 and 3.
Wow, those rolls were awesome!
But now, Bjorn is being attacked 4 times in a row. 2 and 17. Okay, so one that does a hit. 14. Oh, 3 hits on you. Actually, sorry, you have a shield up? No, so that would be only 2 hits on you.
No, he doesn't have a shield up. He's just kicking it across the floor. He's dual-wielding torches.
Wait, no! No, not! No, I'm not dual-wielding torches! I'm here to tank.
He only had one torch. He couldn't take 2 out. So, let's see. From the first hit, you take 7 points of slashing damage. From the second hit, you take 8 points of slashing damage.
What about then also because I'm rage?
That's half. Yeah. You half it. You don't need to. I don't need to tell you that.
I just myself half it. Okay.
Yeah.
Exactly. So
how do you have 7?
To 3. Down. Always down.
Always round down in D&D.
Oh, okay.
There's only one thing in D&D 5e that rounds up, and that is hit dice.
Okay. Okay. Well, there we go.
Okay, let's see what Findira would do this turn.
Findira really doesn't have a lot of options because she's kind of dumb and she hasn't noticed that, like, other than the fact that, like, she's pummeling these things, not really much is happening. And she's just going to keep punching because that's what she does.
Okay, which one do you punch? The one down below or the one up above?
The one down below is on fire, so...
Is it?
It is.
Yeah, that's the one I shot with a flaming arrow.
Yeah, I'm finishing this turn. It's going to go up again.
Can I attack it with a quarterstaff and light the quarterstaff up? Would that work?
No, because the quarterstaff is like massive wood and you need to keep it there until it lights up.
All right. Okay.
Take like 10 minutes or something.
So Findira's just going to keep smashing the hell out of this thing.
If I was a giant, I could create a flaming quarterstaff at will.
But he's not,
so
he can't.
But I'm not, so I can't, I know.
Findira, that is a hit. Hit.
So the first one is the quarterstaff, and then the second is the free action kick.
Okay. Do me those attacks. Bonus action kick him in.
That's what I mean, yeah. Okay. So 10 damage as she quarterstaffs the side of its head and then does a low kick to try and sweep its legs out from under it.
Okay. Now, Finwazi's turn, roll me a 1d4, Finwazi. The fire damage you have done to it increases exponentially, and the creature is now almost half in flames. It does not seem to mind. But it also starts to dwindle like to the sides. Not as stable as before. Finwazi, it's your turn. You have fire arrow, What do you do?
Right, I've just clocked what Gregor's done with that glowing thing, or not glowing thing, whatever.
You just saw what happened,
I'm going to try and move over to the the bottom right hand glowing sort of like sigil.
Okay, so you move over there
and hold it. Yep. Light the fire arrow and try and hold it to the sigil.
Okay, you hold the fire to the sigil. After about 6 seconds at the end of your turn, the sigil goes out, and so does another scarecrow that goes down, shambling on the ground, burning up.
Right, I'm going to shout out, put fire on the sigils, it kills them, do it now.
Gregor.
I don't have any fire.
Well, I don't know then, just keep busy.
Back to me already?
Back to you, my friend.
Alright, I'll move north. Yeah, there's another sigil there. I will try again to... Actually, this one's still lit, so how do you put out something that's lit?
Well, we just saw.
I've just done it with the bottom one, so you know.
Yeah.
I just hold fire against sigil, scarecrow dies. That's all you need to know right now.
Okay. So yeah.
Okay, you hold your torch against the sigil, and the sigil goes out, and so does another scarecrow that goes shambling on the ground. And as you do this, Gregor, you remember a line from the note that was given to you? Keep your eyes
open so you can see the light and the lack of it.
There we go. And Bjorn, Iron Fist, is next. The creatures, as you run at them, they just disappeared. It's just like literally in the ground and started dismembering.
I'm gonna kick one of the helmets across the floor, and then I'm gonna. And then I notice Reggie over here.
Looking quite bad.
I'm shouting to everybody to put fire on the sigils, by the way, so you probably heard that.
You see Reggie white faced,
panicking,
slashed to the face, hand like splinters in his hand.
Afraid, I can almost see him crying slightly as well. There's tears. There are tears, right? So
Neil's
I feel
just
bad.
Concentrating right now.
On the floor, you know.
Yeah, I mean he's almost in tears right now. So I need to get over there fast and save his life because I feel so bad. <faster.
laughs> Neil just realized that we're talking about him.
Poor Neil.
So I'm it's gonna help him.
Everybody pees himself and they're really scared. It's fine.
Exactly. It's only pee. Don't get it on the sigil, but it's okay. It's fine. I'm gonna run on over to the sigil. Wait, my torch is lit now, right?
So yeah, torch is lit.
Throwing it down. Boom.
You throw it down?
No, I don't throw it down. Okay, I'm gonna place it in. I'm gonna place it on the sigil. Okay.
Place it in the sigil. Good job, dude. Good job. And the sigil goes out. And you see the creature in front of you, Neil, just whoop, dismember on the ground.
Can I do actions?
Yeah, you're out of combat.
Cool. Oh, it was more of a, am I paralyzed still?
You're not paralyzed, no.
Cool. What was that?
Scarecrows! Put fire on the sigils, it makes him die, just, I don't know why. Weird magic shit.
I've never understood how scarecrows are supposed to keep away birds, but I get it now. I get it.
Never trust scarecrows!
It also makes sense how you peasants can keep rising up against us if you have such things at your disposal.
Right, mate. Right, yeah.
Did you just call us all peasants?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Are you not a peasant?
Clean your dress up, Reggie.
No,
I'm just gonna be like.
Got your money.
Clasping Bjorn on the shoulder. Thank you, mighty and noble dwarf, for
it's
saving me.
There's still a couple left, aren't they? Thank later, kill now, or you know whatever.
What? I thought we were out of combat.
You're out of combat, yeah?
We killed them all.
You killed them all.
Okay.
Oh, okay. I think they're dead!
Oh, alright. Alright, never mind then.
And your owl goes out.
I think there's... Are there three doors out of here, Chucky?
There are three doors here, yes.
Since this arrow is only lit for a minute, is the arrow still good to fire?
Yeah.
Cool, okay, I'm just gonna...
It's not lit for a minute. A minute is different. This was lit for 12 seconds.
If you need another arrow, I can create one for you.
Nah, you're right, mate. I've seen what happens. I've seen what happens when you try and do magic. Thanks, but no thanks, mate.
Which way? Which way do we go?
You see runes on the doors, but the doors seem unlocked. Actually, the one to the right is slightly ajar open.
So the one to the right's ajar, and the one to the north, and the one to the left.
The one to the north is seems to be the sturdiest of the doors, and the one to the left seems to be about in between.
I push on it really hard.
Which one?
The one on the left.
Okay, so the one that's in between.
Yeah.
Okay, you push on it real hard, and it opens. And let me just open. Copy over your characters to the...
I close it again.
You close it again? Nothing
what?
Happens.
Yeah.
You awkward bastard.
And then I open it. Is it easy to open and close?
It seems reasonably okay, you'd say. It's quite a push. But you can do it. You can make it happen.
The other one's ajar. Okay. Can I push open the door and toss
when
my...
When is a door not a door?
When it's ajar.
Yeah.
I want to open the door, toss my torch in, and see what I see, and then close the door again.
Which one? This one?
The same one, yeah.
Okay, you toss the torch in, and you see iron bars in front of you, a lever to the right side, and a big chamber after that.
Gregor, stop being so afraid. I'm gonna just push Gregor out the side. I'm gonna push Gregor to the side, and I'm gonna boot this door in as well while I'm at it, because I'm a fan of booting in doors, apparently. So I'm just gonna smash it in.
He can go first. That's fine.
Findiris is gonna nod approvingly and follow you.
I'm just gonna kind of sigh and I go, oh jeez, again, really?
Okay, really? You boot in the door. And
I'm gonna carefully stealth in after everybody else is like.
Yeah, I'm gonna stay at the front though. I will stay at the front for sure.
I pick my torch up.
I'll lurk down near the back.
Is this a lever that I see, Chucky?
Yeah, it's a lever.
That is a lever that you see.
So I'm gonna hide behind Reggie.
Immediately upon seeing a lever, Findira is like,
"Oh no!"
That grabs it and just goes. Ugh!
I was gonna ask Reginald to do the pebble thing, but I guess this works too.
As you do that, the bars in front of you open, and the door behind you closes.
I'm gonna ready an arrow.
And this. We take our second break.
All right. I'm going to go and check if the door can actually be opened again. I'm just going to like give it a, like.
You push it, and it seems closed. It seems completely not really closed. Not really openable.
I think we broke it.
Good going. All right. Try pulling that lever again. See what happens.
Okay, and let's take our break there. We'll come back in about 2-3 minutes with more D&D 5e. See you then.